إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، جل عن الشبيه والمثيل والند والنظير، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله.
إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، عباد الله، فقد أخبرنا الله تعالى في آيات كثيرة، وحثنا في آيات كثيرة على ذكره. فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى: فاذكروني أذكركم، واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون. وقال الله تعالى: والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات، أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما. وقال الله تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا. وكثير من هذه الآيات التي تحثنا على ذكر الله عز وجل. ثم زاد في ذلك، فأخبرنا عن طريق رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم في حديث قدسي أن الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول: أنا عند ظن عبدي بي، فإذا ذكرني في نفسه ذكرته في نفسي، وإذا ذكرني في ملأ ذكرته في ملأ خير منهم. يود كل أحد منا أن يذكر أمام العظام، يفرح إن عرف أنه ذكر اسمه أمام شخص عظيم، أمام رئيس دولة، أمام رئيس قسم في العمل، يفرح إن ذكر وإن عرفوا به. فماذا إن ذكرت في خير ملأ، وهو الملأ الأعلى عند الله عز وجل، والله سبحانه وتعالى هو من يذكرك، فهل هناك شرف أعظم من ذلك؟ وتحصل ذلك إذا ذكرت الله في ملأ، أن تذكر الله أمام الملأ، تحث الملأ على ذكر الله عز وجل، فتحصل هذا الشرف العظيم. وقد قال النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم: مثل الذي يذكر ربه ومثل الذي لا يذكر ربه كمثل الحي والميت. أترى الفرق بين الحي والميت؟ هكذا الفرق بين الذاكر لله سبحانه وتعالى والذي يهمل ذكر الله عز وجل. فاختر لنفسك يا عبد الله، أتود أن تكون مع الأحياء، أو تود أن تعد من الأموات بغفلتك عن ذكر الله عز وجل؟ واعلم أن الله سبحانه وتعالى أعد أجرا عظيما للذاكرين له، والأحاديث النبوية مليئة بأذكار الله عز وجل والثواب المترتب على ذلك. ولكن ولنذكر واحدا منهم فقط لنرى أهمية وعظمة ذكر الله عز وجل. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم: من قال لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، وهو على كل شيء قدير، في يوم 100 مرة كتبت له 100 حسنة، كانت له عدل 10 رقاب، لك أجر تحرير 10 رقاب، وكتبت لك 100 حسنة، ومحى الله عنك 100 سيئة، ولم يأتي أحد في هذا اليوم بعمل خير منك إلا أحد فعل هذا العمل. ثم زاد عليه: كل يوم يا عبد الله، كل يوم لديك فرصة لتكون من أفضل خلق الله. عمل لا يأخذ منك أكثر من ربع ساعة أو ثلث ساعة، وتكون من أفضل خلق الله، ولا يتعداك أحد إلا أحد قال هذا الذكر وزاد عليه. فيا عبد الله، إن الأمر بيدك، أن تختار لنفسك ما تكون، فأكثر من ذكر الله، وانتظر الأجر من الله عز وجل. فأقول قولي هذا، وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين، فاستغفروه إنه غفور رحيم. بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه، أما بعد. My respected brothers and elders in Islam, once the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam was with the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, and they were on a journey and they saw a mountain ahead of them, so the Sahaba began to race to that mountain to see who can reach that mountain first. Upon seeing this, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, he said, سَبَقَ الْمُفَرِّدُونَ. The Sahaba asked him, what does that mean, who are al-mufarridun? He said, the mufarridun are those who won the race. So they wanted to know who won the race. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, أَذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ. Those who remember Allah a lot, whether male or female, those are the ones who have won the race. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam used this as an opportunity to teach the Sahaba, yes, you are racing now towards that mountain, but you are all in fact in a bigger race. A race towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A race towards Jannah. A race towards eternal bliss from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you want to win that race, all you have to do is increase in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Increase in saying subhanallah. Increase in saying alhamdulillah. Increase in saying la ilaha illallah. These are the things that help a person win the race. And the reward for remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is great. There's so much ahadith. One of them is that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the example of the one who remembers Allah and the one who doesn't remember Allah is like the difference between the living and the dead. So that shows you the difference. But a reward is something that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I am as my slave remembers me. Oh, I am as my slave thinks of me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, he will be to us like we think of him. If you think highly of Allah, he will give you good for Allah. If you think Allah will not help you, then he will not help you. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and if he mentions me by himself, I will mention him by myself. Just by you sitting down saying subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, you're remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likewise will mention you and will remember you. Such a great blessing. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala adds more, and he says, and if he mentions me in a gathering, then I will mention him in a gathering better than that. You mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in front of the people. You remind the people to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You say the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out loud so people can hear it, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention you by name in a gathering better than the gathering you have mentioned him in. And that is the gathering with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the high angels above, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are happy when we are mentioned, when we realize someone knows us, when we realize someone famous knows us. Or there is a gathering with someone famous and our name is mentioned, we're happy. Or we tell someone, if you're going to meet him, tell him I say hi, tell him I say hello. Let him know I exist. How about if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions you in a gathering far better than any other gatherings in this dunya, which is achieved simply by increasing in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And due to the greatness of reward associated with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu, he said, مَا يَتَحَسَّرُ أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ عَلَى شَيْءٍ إِلَّا سَاعَةً مَرَّتْ بِهِمْ وَلَمْ يَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى فِيهَا. Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu, who was one of the most knowledgeable of the Sahaba, he said, the people of Jannah do not regret except one thing. They're in Jannah. They're in eternal bliss. They're happy with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet they will have one regret. And what is that? He said, a moment that went past in their lives and they did not mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this moment. They did not remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That a minute passed in their lives in the dunya without them saying subhanallah or alhamdulillah or la ilaha illallah. Why do you think that? That is because once they entered Jannah and once they saw the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has associated and has given for the people in Jannah for the remembrance of him, they saw that a person said subhanallah and he got all these gardens. A person said la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah and he got all of these palaces. They saw all of that and they wanted it and they said, how I wish I increased in saying, in remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this dunya. That is the great reward that is associated with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And alhamdulillah, we know this now. So we need to ensure that now we don't have, or we minimize this regret that we have in Jannah when we enter it by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. by utilizing every moment that we have in remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On the journey, whether you're driving a car, whether you're walking, whether you do whatever you're doing, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How easy is it? How difficult is it just to say subhanallah? Something very easy. In fact, a man came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said to him, O Messenger of Allah, the actions of Islam have become difficult for me. There's so much of them. I don't know what to do. Teach me something that if I hold on to it, I will succeed. He said, there's so much things, I don't know what to do. There's so many good things to do. What should I do? What do you think the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him? He said, لَا يَزَالُ لِسَانُكَ رَطِبًا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ. That your tongue should remain moist with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We say this, most of us know this hadith, but what does it mean for your tongue to be moist with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The tongue is a piece of flesh in your body that remains in moisture inside your mouth. You take your tongue out of your mouth for a few seconds and it dries up. And it needs to return back into the mouth, into the moisture. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, moisten your tongue. Keep your tongue moist with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just like your tongue cannot remain for a few seconds outside the mouth, it needs to go back into moisture. Your tongue should not allow a few seconds to go past without remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is what it means to keep your tongue moist with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And with that is how a person achieves success. Because it's not just the actions, the sounds that you're making, or the remembrance, just saying with your tongue. No, it's what settles in your heart. It's the fact that you feel closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That brings you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's the fact that when you are saying this, and if you are saying this with contemplation, you are pondering over the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is what brings you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is an action that we need to ensure we increase in. We need to make sure we say a lot of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to show you how much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves this, and how much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps a person in this situation, we all know the story of Yunus alayhi salam, who was swallowed by the fish or the whale, and then he was rescued after. But the details of it is that when Yunus alayhi salam was in the whale, he said, La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. There is none worthy of worship except you, glory be to you, I have been from the wrongdoers. So he was remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when he remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is reported that the angels heard him. The angels high above with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they heard him. And they recognized his voice. Why? Because he used to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before this calamity that befell upon him. He used to always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore when he fell into this calamity and he remembered Allah and he called upon Allah, the angels recognized his voice. And they said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a familiar voice from an unfamiliar location. We know this voice, but we don't know where it's coming from. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to them, that is my slave Yunus. Then the angel said, oh Allah, will you not save him? So not only was he asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save him, he had the angels high above with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala interceding for him, and also asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save him. That is what a person who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gets. He remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot, and when he is in difficulty and he asks Allah, it's not just him asking Allah, it's the angels also asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on his behalf. Because the angels know this person, they are familiar with him, they recognize him, they love that person. And they too ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for him. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. Had it not been that he was from those who would constantly remember Allah, he would have remained in the stomach of the whale until the day of judgment. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it clear in the Quran, the thing that saved Yunus alayhi salam is the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is what saved him. And that is not something specific to Yunus alayhi salam. It is something that every single one of us can get. Just increase in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he taught us many things. Many, many supplications we can do. He taught us things to say in the morning and the evening. Things to say after you complete the prayer. Things to say when the wind blows. When you hear thunder. All of these things that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us. And inshallah we will be giving you a book at the end which mentions all of these remembrances, and as well as the reward associated with them. It's not that they just save you, there's also reward associated with them. Like the one we mentioned in Arabic, whoever says, La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, lahu al-mulk wa lahu al-hamdu wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. He says that 100 times in a day takes you no more than 15-20 minutes. Says that 100 times in a day, he will have the reward of fearing 10 slaves. He will have 100 good deeds written for him. He will have 100 sins erased from him. And no one will come to Allah, will do something on that day better than him, except a person who does that and he does more. So every day we have the opportunity to be the best in that day. Every day, every single one of us has the opportunity to be the best and the closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that day by saying this 100 times. La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, lahu al-mulku lahu al-hamdu wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. Saying that 100 times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say this is the best person that day. The only one who does better than him is the one who does the same and does more good deeds. And not many people do this. Not many people say this 100 times a day. So it's your opportunity to be the best. And every day you have that opportunity. So try and familiarize yourself with these remembrances. And the beautiful thing about them is that they are recommended actions. They are actions, if you miss out on them, you are not punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if you do them, you are rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if some days you forget, that's fine. Try and be consistent as much as possible. But you're not held to account if you forget or if you don't say these things. But you are rewarded greatly by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has associated for the reward, what He stipulated as the reward for those who do recommended actions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَنْ عَادَ لِي وَلِيًّا فَقَدْ أَذَنْتُهُ بِالْحَرْبِ وما تقرب إلي عبد بعمل أحب إلي مما افترضته عليه ولا يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, my slave will continue doing recommended actions to come closer to me حتى أحببته أو حتى أحبه, until I love him. فإذا أحببته كنت سمعه الذي يسمع به وبصره الذي يبصر به ويده التي يبطش بها ورجله التي يمشي بها. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, a person will continue doing recommended actions. So these forms of remembrance are recommended actions. He will continue to do them until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love him. You think that's enough? No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has got more for you. And if I love him, I will be the voice which he speaks, the eyes with which he sees, the hands with which he moves, and the feet which he uses. And what this means is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will allow you to have healthy limbs and allow you to use them in a way that pleases him. And you think that's it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala added more. And if he asks of me, then I will give him. And he will seek. And if he seeks refuge in me, then I will give him protection. This is, and if he calls upon me, then I will answer his dua. You get all of this just by doing increasing in recommended actions. And the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one of the best forms of recommended actions. So Ramadan is round the corner, and we want to make sure we do the best in Ramadan. So try and get yourself in a habit where you increase in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even if sometimes your mind becomes absent, don't allow your tongue to stop remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You won't get the best reward if your mind is absent, but you will get some reward for the movement of your tongue. But always try and keep your mind and your heart present to increase in the reward. So try and memorize some of these. Try to get into a habit of increasing the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say the remembrance that is to be said every morning and every evening. Not only are you rewarded for it, but you're also protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through it. Say the remembrance that you say after the salah, the remembrance that you say before going to bed. All of these forms of remembrance, trying to be familiar with them, particularly in Ramadan and throughout the end of your life, and you will see miracles from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will see how when you're in times of difficulty, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save you, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will find a way out for you, all through the remembrance of Allah, because Allah then loves you. And that is exactly what we seek. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to be from those who increase in His remembrance. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be from those who mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in large gatherings. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to be from those who say the morning and evening supplications. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be from those who say the supplications before going to bed, the supplications after salah, the supplication when hearing the wind, the supplication when hearing the thunder, and to be people who emulate the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to be from those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين بخفي لطفك فرج الهم عن المهمومين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يذكرك كثيرا. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يذكرك كثيرا. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يذكرك كثيرا وتقبل منا يا رحمن يا رحيم. اللهم بلغنا رمضان. اللهم بلغنا رمضان. اللهم بلغنا رمضان ويسر لنا العمل الصالح في رمضان وتقبله منا يا رحمن يا رحيم. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون.
لا إله إلا الله.